Hi guys, thanks for joining me for another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today I'm going to be going over how to create a color palette from a document, right after this. Okay, so before we get started, go ahead and look in the description and you'll find a link, download link, to download this ping pong paddle illustration, if you would like to work along with me. Okay, so this tutorial is about creating a palette from this document. So what a palette does is it takes all the colors that are in here and it just sort of puts it into separate colors that you can access easily. And you don't have to keep using the color picker right up here. So this is actually my first tutorial on swatches. So you're going to go ahead and click on the swatches panel. I would recommend this if you're doing like a pattern or like a big design, so that you can maintain your colors. So when you click on your swatches panel, I'll go into depth about the swatches panel a little bit later, but just going to show you how to create a swatch palette. So click up here, this little menu up here, and click on create a palette from document, and then you can create as a document palette or application palette or system palette. So I'm going to go ahead and click document palette. And here it takes all the colors from the different blues and everything and sticks it right here. And since this layer is called ping pong and it was selected on the ping pong, it automatically called it ping pong. So here's your thing, and it created a document. So you won't be able to access this in when you open new files. If you want to make it so you can access it when you make use new files, you just click create palette from document, and then click use application palette, and it will make a little Affinity Designer, a little Affinity logo here by the ping pong, and then it will show up in all your documents if you need that palette for like all your documents. This is especially useful if you have a logo and you just like lots of your designs, you know, have the same color in your logo and all the marketing that goes into that. That's one of the uses, and there's many other uses that you could use this for. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any questions, comments, or encouragements, please comment in the area below, and please give this video a like. I'm trying to get as many people to like this video as possible, and also if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, and you'll get free Affinity Designer tutorial in depth as well. And I try to I'm trying to come out with as many tutorials as possible. I'm going to be coming out with lots of tutorials when this next update hits, and so go ahead and hit subscribe. Thanks for watching this tutorial.